305.
That's right, guys. I'm Colin from Hollywood Studios, and today I will be reviewing Intimidator 305, the Intamin Giga Coaster at King's Dominion. Oh my god, is this coaster intense? Yeah, I've had some pretty intense rides on the coasters like Sky Rush and King Ka and even El Toro, but none of those rides compare to the intensity level of this ride. This ride is absolutely mental. Now, so you guys are aware, I rode this 10 times in one day. Don't do it, because the after effects of this ride from riding 10 times in one day, it's not worth it to ride 10 times in one day. So I rode in a lot of different seats. I rode it in the front row, back row. Didn't really ride it too much in the middle because, you know, the middle's not always the greatest on coasters. But to a point, this coaster is too intense. I'll get into that a little later. But there's a reason why it's not my number one. And that's because some of these snap turns, right? The really snappy transitions, they're a little too much. Like, I'll be posting a Maverick review very soon. And Maverick, it has snap turns like this too, but you're not traveling 80-something miles an hour through these turns. Oh no. On Maverick, you're going like 50-something, and that's about it. So they're tolerable on Maverick. On Intimidator 305, specifically if you're tall, because my dad kind of felt this more than I did. If you're tall, your neck, during these snap turns, kind of gets caught on the top of the restraint, so your head is just flying all over the place. And I can see how it can cause a lot of discomfort. After riding this, still now, I can feel it in my head. Like, the pure intensity of this ride is kind of almost too much. And after we rode it that day, later that day, when we got to Williamsburg at our hotel, my dad had a horrible headache, and that kind of shows how this coaster is too intense. But getting into the ride itself, it is 305 feet tall, as you can kind of figure out from the name. I mean, Intimidator 305, 305 feet tall. Sorry. It goes 90 miles an hour, and you're reaching this maximum speed at the bottom of the first drop, going through this like hard bank, and that is where you will gray or even black out. I got tunnel vision, and for those of you who don't know what that is, tunnel vision is basically when you're on the verge of blacking out after you gray out, but you're not quite there yet. That's what I felt on I-305, and it's one unique feeling for sure. This coaster is a little over 5,000 feet long, so it's a pretty long ride. Not so much in duration, because you're going so fast through these elements. The ride is over quite quickly. And it doesn't have any inversions, and I'm glad it doesn't, because that would just push the intensity level, too much. But now we get into the ride. First of all, the theming, the whole area. I mean, first of all, it's kind of located in the African section of the park, which, if you ask me, that makes no sense to have a racing coaster, a coaster themed to racing, in an African section. What is the logic in that? But anyways, getting around that, the coaster is actually themed quite well. It's themed to Dale Earnhardt, who was nicknamed the Intimidator. He was a NASCAR racer, and unfortunately, he did pass away in an accident, but I'm here to talk about the coaster, not Dale Earnhardt. But the theming, it has a lot about Dale Earnhardt. And the theming, like the front of the train, actually, it looks like the front of Dale Earnhardt's car, which I thought was really cool. Anyways, you're going to ascend up this humongous cable lift hill, and you will hear Dale Earnhardt, right before you begin ascending, yell, "Gentlemen, start your engines." And I really like that. It kind of gets the whole mood going, and it adds to the theming a little bit. And this lift hill is really fast. You're at the top in about 20 seconds, and it's just super quick. And then you dive down this 85-degree drop. Wow. In the front or back, this drop is just phenomenal. I didn't expect to get so much ejector floater air on that drop, but I did, and it was crazy. And then you're going to turn into the famous turn. The turn where everyone grays and blacks out. So, you really don't feel the G's until you're starting to come up and rise into that humongous airtime hill. I remember out of all the 10 rides I got, I grayed out and tunnel visioned every time. And I felt, I didn't black out, but I almost did on one ride in the front row. Because I guess the combination of the wind and the G-force really got to me, and I couldn't believe it. But you're going to rise over that airtime hill under the lift hill. You get some nice floater over that. And then come the snap turns. Now, if you're sitting in the left seat and you're prepared for these turns, they're not bad. I actually get a little bit of airtime over them too. But if you're tall, like, you know, over 5'5", and you're not ready for these turns, it's not going to feel good. And that's the main problem with this ride. Either you like it or you don't. I happen to like it, but the turns can be a little too much. And so that's my main complaint about the ride. Other than that, the ride is phenomenal. But after these snap turns, you'll go into another turn, come back over by the drop, and go through these two consecutive airtime hills. And you do have a trim break on the first airtime hill, but I actually don't mind that trim, actually, because if you ask me, if that trim weren't there, you'd probably break your neck on the last couple elements just because of all that speed you have. And you'd probably, and you still get pretty good airtime over those hills, especially later in the day. You're getting ejector over those hills, even with the trim. So I can't imagine how forceful the end of the ride would be without those trims. It'd be too much. So finally, after that, after those two consecutive airtime hills, you fly into the last snap turn before rising up into the brakes, going through yet another snap transition. And so ends the most intense coaster in the world, or at least from what I've ridden. Yes, I believe this is the most intense coaster I've ridden. Now, let's bring me to my main complaints about this ride. My only complaint about this ride is the snappy transitions. They're a little too snappy. I think if they just smoothed them out a little bit more, they would have been completely tolerable. Other than that, I have no complaints. This ride is glossy smooth, no roughness at all, even on back-wheeled seats. The ride, it's so good. And the restraints are very comfortable. They're those soft over-the-shoulder Intamin restraints. So they're not painful at all. Wish King Dakar would get those restraints, but that's a video for another day. And for Intimidator 305's final score, of course I'm giving it a 10. If you ask me, that is the best ride at King's Dominion. Not by much, though. Twisted Timbers is right behind it. But again, Twisted Timbers, that's a topic for another video. But I hope you guys enjoyed my review. Again, Intimidator 305, you got to get your butts down there or up there, depending on where you live, if you haven't been there already. I-305, King's Dominion, the whole park, that ride, it's just great. So that'll end this review of I-305 at King's Dominion. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Be sure to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye, guys.